Hey, what's up, everybody, fellow ham radio operators and other folks out there. Welcome to my house and my Wires X node. I'm going to show you guys the Wires X. So let's start off first with the radio. This is a Yaesu FTM-100DR. Well, it says 100D, but it's DR if you go to order one. Anyway, this is a VHF, UHF, FM, and C4FM digital transceiver. Has GPS built in with it, APRS, all that good stuff. I ran this guy mobile for quite some time. I think like maybe a year and a half or so before I upgraded to the FTM-400XDR, which is a fantastic rig. I can't do two thumbs up at the same time because I'm holding the phone. Anyway, so here's the Wires X node. Now what this does, if you guys are unfamiliar with Wires X, this is Yaesu's internet linking repeater enhancement system. Wireless internet linking repeater, it stands for something like that. Anyway, so what this allows me to do here, here's the software that's running. So what this allows me to do is connect to people over the internet and use this like a digital repeater, and so I can talk to people all over the place, and I can connect to like a whole bunch of different rooms, which I'll show you that here in just a second. So you can talk all over from the comfort of your easy chair. So I use my FT70 to access my node. In fact, let me connect to it. Let me turn it back on here. So it just transmitted, my node will come back. There we go. All right, so I'm connected. So now I can steer this thing anywhere I want to, which is pretty nice. Meet some new friends, even at, you know, well, there's folks that say, you know, radio over internet isn't real radio, but hey, it is. I've got this guy set on low power, and it's connected to a Tram 1480 that's on a 30-foot pole, and I can get a good 20-25 miles coverage from my mobile to my base radio with crystal clear audio. It's pretty cool. Let me go through the setup here, and I'll show you. This is an old radio case or record player case that I found at a... It was like a junk sale, I guess. Anyway, I found two of them, and I was like, yeah, it'd be pretty cool to sit on the desk and put the radios and stuff in there. So anyway, that's why I've got the radios mounted in here. You can't really tell. I've got a big cooling fan right there. I can stick my finger in it almost. But so that keeps the radio nice and cool. There is a switching power supply. Plenty of power. That's a 50-amp power supply. And of course the old trusty rusty Dell laptop up there, 630 D630, so that kind of tells you how old it is. I think on the bottom of this thing it says it's specifically made for Windows XP, but I've got a solid state drive in it, so that helps out quite a bit. Anyway, let me shut the lid on that. I'll show you what is underneath. All right, and I don't think I lost anything. I got a power switch. I've got my Wires X HRI 200. That was about $125. And my node numbers and room numbers, I put that on there so I wouldn't forget. And anyway, it connects here via USB and to the old laptop. That seems to be working out pretty good. I can either control the node here, or I can do it with the HT. Let me go through. There's Texas Nexus, Oklahoma Link. Let's go to my room. Nobody ever talks here, but that was the Guns and Ham group. So we'll connect there, and then look at that. I wonder who that guy is. Yeah, it might be me. Anyway, so there's the Guns and Ham group, and I've got them saved in here. Every node has like a 5-digit ID. Let's see if we can catch some chatter. Let's go to Texas Nexus. My buddy's on Texas Nexus. This is Monday at like 6:30 in the afternoon. Let's try America Link. Should be some stuff going on there.
Let's
transmit from my radio and M6 VNE. He's talking. It'll show it here. M6 VNE. There he is.
Yeah, very good. Well, I haven't been on very long myself. I've only been on 3 or 4 weeks, something like that. So we're still learning everything also. But yeah, the hotspot that you're running there, I'm not sure which one it is, but that's what I'm running here too, is a Zoom spot, hotspot, and we're running a Yaesu FT70 into it. So if it's saying waiting, you probably dropped your connection momentarily. You might want to just play around with that a little bit.
Let me give them a break and I'll go to...
Sometimes when the internet connection gets flaky, sometimes it'll drop the connection. It'll say waiting. Go.
There we go. There's my chance. There we go. Back on Oklahoma Link, which is normally where my station stays. But also to remote access my node or laptop right here is I use VNC. This is just the computer right next to it. But I can also use my iPad and use a VNC viewer. VNC viewer. Right there. There you go. And so I can use my iPad and I can connect to this thing to make sure it's online, move it. Like I said, I get like, 20, 25 miles, sometimes more, just off the node radio here on low power. And it seems to do just as well on low power as it does on medium power. I hadn't really tried it on high power. Sometimes it gets pretty chatty, but anyway. I figured I'd show you guys my my Wires X node setup, and there you go. That I pretty much just chill out. I use that when I'm out in the mobile, driving around. I can connect to it, steer around, catch conversation after I've burned out all my good luck on the local repeaters and nobody's around during the day, so you can normally find somebody and just chat on the radio. Driving around all the time and good conversation. So anyway, hope you guys liked the video, and I'll get it uploaded. It'll already be uploaded by the time you watch this. It was a silly statement. Anyway, 73 guys, thanks for watching. And hope you enjoyed it. Hope to catch you on Wires X sometime. 73 all N5 XTR. Take care. Have a great day.